The people.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
So, there's so much bullshit that happened with this, and both parties, and I'm not completely convinced that the guy in San Diego is a hit guy, but I'm not convinced.
Yeah, I'm not convinced of that either.
Yeah.
Cause they were in a bind.
Yeah, well, but how do you not make sure that you know that you're turning over 300, let's just call it 300, but I still think it's more like 350 or more. But let's just call it 300. How do you not make sure that before those animals even leave your own facility, that they're not going someplace that they're gonna be safe? You've never done business with Humane Society of Southern Arizona before. And they're all privately owned. They're all called Humane Societies, but they're not part of an organization. It never was incorporated.
But isn't you want it started on you, because you wanted to know?
Yep. I'm pretty sorry for that now.
Yeah.
I think they figured they're just gonna point the finger at Humane Society, and our Humane Society is like, they immediately hired this investigator because they needed to clear themselves. Well, at the end of the day, you guys are just responsible because you put that piece of garbage in. Nobody at the Humane Society wanted him. All of the employees and all the volunteers that had an opportunity to meet him during the interview process, none of them wanted him. They didn't like him. And so in the report, which I thought was really interesting, because I read it the other night, the report that they released from the investigator, that one of the things that he's recommending is that from two different parts, from the clinic side and from the adoptions or whatever side, admission side of the shelter, that a representative from both of those areas are involved with the hiring of the next CEO, and that they need to insist that the next one coming on board has that in their operation. He had zero. It was politics and it was due to good fundraising. That's why he hired him. And that speaks to the culture of the board. And that's where the problem with Humane Society has been all these years, because they're the ones, it's all about the money, that's all they care about. He was pulling 10 dogs a week from Cochise. They never even made it into, they were euthanized in the parking lot. And he was getting paid $10 a dog. Not 10 dogs, 6 dogs every week, $10 a dog. $600 a week that Cochise was paying him to come kill their dogs. Tell me Cochise doesn't know that that's what's happening. You don't get to hire. I know him now. I've been doing this too long. You all know exactly what's happening. These dogs don't show up on a website anymore. Where are they? Where'd they go?
Well, who's giving them
the $10? And here's the thing. Cochise doesn't have to claim them as against their live release rate because they left their shelter live. So that's a live outcome. The Humane Society, it doesn't count against them because if they kill them before they bring them to
kill, whatever, supposedly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the Humane Society doesn't have to claim them because if they kill them in the parking lot before they become a part of your system, then those numbers don't count.
Yeah, they never saw them.
They're so freaking sketchy. That's why I had a laugh in the PACAC meetings when Steve used to call Kristen and now Monica on the carpet for things. You're a lying piece of crap.
Yeah.
This is what your organization's been doing for 20 years. PAC has to document every day, every animal that they kill. There's records. You can subpoena all of them. You can request it under freedom of information. They have to give it to you because it's a municipal shelter. Yeah. It blew open, and then so many volunteers and former staff have come out and started talking about all of this stuff that happened during their time there. Pat Hubbard, that's whose name I couldn't remember a few weeks ago. So Pat was the head person at the Humane Society for a long time. And her daughter-in-law worked at the Humane Society. She'd been there for something like 33 years. So she gave notice, this is almost 2 years ago now. She gave notice, she gave them 3 weeks, and she said, so that you can have a chance to bring somebody in, or if you want to do it internally for now, I'll stay longer so that I can train somebody on what I do, and then that way you're not in a big rush to find someone. They told her, today's your last day. If you sign an NDA, or no, a non-disparagement, that's what it was, not a non-disclosure, a non-disparagement agreement, meaning that you're not going to say anything negative about us after you leave, then we will pay you your last 3 weeks of pay. If you refuse, you're fired now. Get out. 33 years, and she was Pat's daughter-in-law. Pat was dead, they didn't care. Pat's not here anymore, we don't have to think about. That's the culture. That's what he did. So, money to him now, you're reaping everything you need.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah. I just hope they go with the dad.
The best thing that happened was those animals crossed state lines.
Mountain ahead of the enemy out there, so it's scary, but you can't quit, not to do that anymore.
Yep. I think both parties now, both sides, have gotten in so deep, they're like, maybe we should have done this. Maybe we should have just fired them quietly and not let them in.
Yeah, I'm so glad they did do it though.
Yeah, well, they were both looking to clear their names of what it was. But that shows you the level of arrogance of the boards on both, both groups. She sleeps really creepy. She gets in this weird position where she cranes her neck.
She's like a contortion.
And then her eyes roll back in her head.
It's so quiet. Everybody's sleeping.
I was so worried what this week was gonna be like because they were all the lucky that ran in.
Has he been out?
And it's been.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he went with the guy.
Ryan took him out.
Not that long ago.
Oh, I thought the guy did. Didn't the guy that was.
No.
Okay.
So.
That doesn't seem right.
That's what I'm saying. I'm smelling like a.
He keeps farting.
Is that you?
Okay. It might be.
Is that you doing that?
Yeah, it's him. I kept standing here and I'm like, look here. You walk past me. And then go sit with the dog.
She's got some sparks too.
Yeah. And then you over there, ooh, and I kept smelling it, and I was by myself. Like, for me.
He was stinky yesterday afternoon too. He doesn't stink if you like smell him. You're very handsome. Very handsome.
Okay, just in case you decide you want to take senior party pants.
You need to go out, buddy? You are excited about that.
He said, I'd love to go out.
I'd like to take them off. Okay, lucky you get out. This is fine. All right, let's do it.
Do you want to go out?
They all have a. Have you noticed when you pet him, Ryan, that if you go like this with his hair, it totally feels like Sharpay hair?
Yeah.
I think he's got Sharpay hair.
Sharpay hair.
You know, I'm gonna put you in one of those cabinets. I'll fold you up like a front door. You're in one of those cabinets.
Yeah, pretty people in on Sunday. Oh, it's gorgeous. It's famous.
Yeah.
Okay, did she need anything like additionally, or I know that the lady that brought her back said that she had diarrhea. She was jumping up on everybody. She was so happy. Her tail, she was wagging like crazy. She was so happy.